Hi there. In this video, we are going to be taking a look at an external hard drive case for 2.5 inch hard drive or SSD from ineo. So let's get into this box. And inside the box, we have the rugged case itself, at which we'll be taking a look now. This feels like aluminium or aluminum, depending on what country you are from. This is rubber, and the fact that it has the USB cable included and tucked in right here is a huge bonus. Let's see if I can get it out with one hand. Hopefully I can, and probably I can. So as you can see, USB type C, and it's actually a decently long cable, longer than you would actually expect to find. This thing has, let's see, 30 or even 35 centimeters, but presumably 30 centimeters. So let's see how you would actually put a hard drive in it. Going deeper into the box, we have a foam which will probably act as a spacer with glue on one side, 3M glue, and the key, it's a Torx to open up the enclosure itself. So we will be opening it up and see how we can connect a hard drive. And just quickly take a look also at this. Let's get back to this because my wife and daughters came in like a hurricane and I needed to stop. So, screwdriver for this, which we will open in a moment. But let's quickly take a look the website if you need it. Let's quickly take a look at the specs. Paper, open please. So, integrated, yes. There are two model numbers with type A or type C, and I'm glad that they sent me this. And yes, thank you ineo for sending this unit, because I'm trying to get all my devices into this kind of connector. Much smaller, more convenient in my opinion, much better in laptops. So yeah, there's that. Screws, warranty and user manual. Yes, warranty card is right here if you need to see it. Here it is, you can pause for any info on it. So it is USB 3.1 Gen 2. 2.5 inch SATA. And let's see, yeah, the requirements obviously are quite low. And unpack until you are ready to install it. Yes, do not drop or jolt the product. Do not move the external storage. I've seen many people doing this in YouTube videos. While the hard drive was connected to a laptop or PC, they were copying data and they were moving this thing all around. Don't do that. Laptops, mechanical hard drives don't like to be moved while they are working. Yes, they are able to handle that. They are built to handle movement because they are put in laptops. So, yeah, but still not a good idea. Inside of it, it's a mechanical head writing data and you are also moving this. So, why would you do that? If it's an SSD inside, then the movement is has no importance at that point in time. Anyway, so that's about it. Nothing on this side. Let's get it open off video. It's quite simple. You lefty loosey and then righty tighty. And let's put an SSD in it. So it's opened up. A piece of quite thick aluminium, actually. Thicker than I expected it to be. This is rubber, and inside we have a plastic frame onto which the rubber sits. So make sure you insert the hard drive at an angle camera focus today, and slowly push it and wiggle it and lower it down. And presumably at this point we put this on it, but I think I am going to be putting it on the aluminium plate. So peel off the protection from it's not double-sided tape, I wanted to say double-sided tape, but no, it's a cushion tape with glue on only one side, and stick it in here. So be back in a second. And it's in place. You could put it on this, but if you ever change the disc inside, then you don't have that anymore. So if I put it here, it will always be there. But keep in mind, this is a 7.5 millimeter SSD, the thickness of it. So from what I see here, a 9 millimeter enters this enclosure for sure. But higher, for example, 11 millimeter, that I do not know. It's better to you send an email to ineo and ask if that is compatible, because I don't have thicker drives to test at the moment. So for me, this SSD is in there, and put this back. Make sure the rubber is in place, because it can come out and be cut and catch something like this, and that would be bad. That's not normal. It needs to be flush in there, and simply put this in here and put all six screws in position. And then let's give this a quick speed test. Yes, I hope we are not exceeding the limit, the speed limit of the SSD. In theory, we are not. Presumably, this will be the limit, the USB connection, but we will see. And it's closed up and looking sharp. And yes, I am working directly on the carpet. Not ideal. I just moved into a new location, and sadly I don't have my workspace in order to work there, so that will be done in the future. But I've never killed any components by working on this carpet, so yeah, but don't do it. If you have a better space like a desk, maybe even an ESD mat or something, use that, obviously. So let's power on the laptop and connect this to it and give it a quick speed test and see what we get. And obviously we have an M.2 SSD in that. This is the speed of the NVMe SSD in the laptop. So if we see lower transfer numbers than this, obviously this is not the limiting factor. I just did a test to show you that not the internal disk is the limiting factor. Let's plug in the external hard drive for the first time. Snug connection. Already recognized. So that's great. And the SSD in this thing is an NGFF. I mispronounced that. NVMe SSD. So again, it will not be the limiting factor for any transfer between these two. And it already sees it, which is perfect. So let's do some testing. Just want to mention before the tests, this is my laptop model, and it is equipped with USB 3.2 Gen 1 in two types of ports. So either the standard port or type C. And that means that its maximum theoretical speed is, as you can see here, old USB 3.0, now commonly referred to as 3.1 Gen 1, it's 625 megs per second. So that's the maximum theoretical speed that it could ever reach. And if you got confused, because I was showing speeds for 3.1, although my laptop says it has 3.2, well, USB 3.2 Gen 1 by 1, which is in my laptop, is identical to USB 3.1 Gen 1 and old USB 3.0. Crystal Disk Mark test is running on our external hard drive. And what we are starting to see here looks good in my opinion. It's good enough for an external hard drive. Yep. Obviously with SSD inside, not with a mechanical spinning platters hard drive that would have way lower numbers than this. So I'm going to let it finish and then do a direct copy from the SSD in the laptop, the NVMe one, to this and see how it looks like in direct copy of a 5 gig file or something like that. So let's let this thing finish. And yes, for these numbers, the SSD inside could potentially partially be the limiting factor. I do not know. I honestly never tested the SSD inside of this by itself directly connected to an SATA port in the laptop or in a desktop PC, so I have no clue if it can do better than this or not. But anyway, for an external drive, these are good numbers and enough for me, at least for sure. And the test is finished. Here are the numbers once again for an external USB drive. Good enough in my opinion. Let's close this thing and take a file from F drive. Let me just show you that I already have some data on the SSD that I put in the enclosure. So these are the partitions on that SSD. So F drive is on the SSD from the enclosure. This is how we see the enclosure. Okay, so let's take this thing and move it to C drive. Yes, continue, whatever, more details. And this is the speed that we are getting. Yep. Good enough in my book. So, what can I say? I like this thing. Let me try if I and see if I can fool this. Rename this thing. Show more options. Jeez, I hate Windows 10 a little bit. Not a lot, but I do hate it a little bit. Continue, yes, whatever. Let's see if I can drag this back and we see the speed in the opposite direction. So this is the write speed on the same drive. That initially was the read speed and this is the write speed. So a bit lower, but still compared to what I was used to a few years ago, this is, it's enough. It does the thing. I'm going to let it finish, although I don't need that particular data, but I'm not going to stop it. So what I can say is that I fully like this product. I can move it because it's not a spinning hard drive. Rubberized, quite sturdy, thick aluminium. If you bend this aluminium, you have bigger problems. Something really bad happened. Back protected by rubber, sides protected by rubber. This thing goes all the way around and into that hole right there. I didn't even see we have a LED. So yes, we have an activity and power LED. That's cool. Is it also an activity LED? Let me do something. Let's shift delete. Yep, it's also activity. Good. So thank you, ineo, for sending this thing. It will be put to good use. As honestly, I will be replacing my thumb drive that's old and slow and quite worn out. I will be replacing with this thing because I can just throw this into my backpack without worrying at all about it. Not having also spinning components inside, that's even a bonus. And be done with it. So, hope this video helps you. In case it does, please give it a like. Check out my other videos and as always, see you in the next one. Bye. And yes, always safe eject your drives. And obviously, it's ready to be put to work. Bye once again.